Take a wide stance. And breathe in, your arms travel up. Exhale, the wrists float down. We'll do this again, breathing up. This time, energy out your fingers, and we'll do this one more time and hold it at the top. Cross it up. The arms come down and through. Cross your ankles. I've put you into the whole brain posture so that we can pull from muscle and cerebral memory what we need for a ball class today, a fitness ball class. With that, let's uncross. Bring your palms together. Look straight ahead, eyes open. Look down, your cheeks, eyes open. Relax your shoulders and close your eyes. Release it. Move around just a little bit. And step to the very back of your mat. We'll get warmed up. Breathe in, and as you exhale, drop your chin. Walk down the legs. Onto the mat, toward the front of it, and into the down face dog. You have all 10 toes equally on the floor. Now breathe. As you exhale, press back. You get that great stretch in the backs of your legs. Breathe in again. As you exhale, knees come down carefully and uncurl the toes. Palms under your shoulders, knees under your hips. Breathe in and scoop the belly up. As you exhale, let it drop. We'll do that again. Scoop and subtle core together. Hold those two as you exhale, feel them deepen. Hold as you inhale, as you exhale, deepen again. Tuck the pelvis a little. Breathe here as you exhale, round up into the cat. Holding, breathing, feel your stretch up and down the spine. And then we'll let this drop into the old cow, softening the elbows and looking up. Scoop your belly, let that motivate you. Up, up, up into the cat again. Holding, breathing, get your stretch. And then reorient into the old cow and look up. Come back to the middle. Both palms move forward one step. And take the torso forward as you breathe. Exhale, press back. Do it again. Inhale forward and exhale back. Gliding forward, sits bones come together. Pressing back, they widen apart. And we'll do one more articulation in your sacroiliac joint. Come back to the middle and your palms move under the shoulders again. Close your eyes, scoop your belly, breathe as you exhale, right hand, left knee hover. And then slowly extend that arm and leg out and up to shoulder and hip height. Breathing, feeling your stabilizers activate. And then slowly retrace those. Eyes still closed, belly scooped, and do the other pair. Breathe as you exhale, left hand, right knee. Glide the mounted up to shoulder and hip height and hold here, breathing. As you exhale, put this set back down. Down you go and open your eyes. Breathe here as you exhale, pinch your right waist and look over your shoulder. See if you can see your hip. Let's take this through the middle to the left and look left. Through the middle to the right, looking right. Feet and fingers pivot right, breathe. As you exhale, round up. Into that weird cat, holding, breathing, get the stretch on your left, drop to a neutral, through the middle you go, flip everything to the left, inhale, and exhale, round it up again, feeling the stretch on the right side this time, drop this to a neutral, come back to the middle, sit off on either hip, the feet come forward with the heels at the end of the mat. So we're holding behind the legs. Breathe in long through your spine. As you exhale, drop your chin. Scoop and tuck your pelvis and start to roll it back. Each vertebra goes down in a long sequence to your head. Stretch the arms out over your head. Breathe. As you exhale, retrace the arms. The head comes up. Pull behind your legs and pull yourself up, up, and up. Knees wide, come forward and breathe wide across your back, filling in the sides. And then stay curved, we'll take it back down again, rolling over the sits bones. Hold behind the legs to support this articulation to your head. Stretch the arms out over your head, breathe, and retrace again. Head, shoulders, pull yourself up with your hands. Knees wide, breathe wide across your back. Then stack it up to a flat back. Hinge back like a door. Inhale. As you exhale, scoop and tuck the pelvis and chin and take this all the way to the floor. This time, stretch arms and legs out and breathe into a full body stretch. Bring your arms to your sides and move both feet in towards your glutes. Let's check in with bony landmarks, making up your neutral spine. All 10 toes, the bottoms of your feet flat and weighted. You feel your sacrum bone heavy and triangular. The lumbar curves mid-back to the backs of the shoulders on the floor. The back of your neck curves and the back of the head is on your neutral spine. Squeeze between your shoulders and your rhomboids. The backs of your shoulders press down. Triceps, elbows, forearms, and palms press down. Breathe here as you exhale, rhomboid to palms. Super engage, press into the floor. It lifts your ribs and spine up, up, feeling the strength of your platform arm system. Breathe here as you exhale, release the arms back into neutral for contrast. Stay in neutral and come into your core. Scoop the belly, subtle core. Ribs close as you exhale. Your lats connect, that little armpit to hip, rhomboid arm thing. Breathe. As you exhale, stabilize your core in neutral, then press down, down to the arms, feeling the two systems work against each other. Breathe here as you exhale, release it all for contrast. Stay in neutral and refresh your core. Scoop, subtle core. Ribs close as you exhale. Your lats connect. Breathe here and slowly motivate from behind the shoulders to lift some soft, heavy arms up toward the ceiling. Elbows stay kicked out to the sides a little. Over the head they go. Come to rest about 20 centimeters or so over the floor. You're breathing, feeling the work it takes to keep ribs closed. Belly scooped, spine neutral. Breathe. As you exhale, stable, use those same muscles to float the arms back up toward the ceiling, keeping pectorals and biceps soft, out of the picture, and then back down they go. The arms still feel heavy behind your shoulders. When they're down, refresh your core. Exhale, stabilizing, and slowly float your right bent knee up toward the ceiling. Holding at the top, breathe. As you exhale, stable, take your right heel down, down, and put it on the floor. Glide the heel out, slide it back, and slowly take it to the top again. Holding there, inhale. Exhale, stable, left knee floats up to meet the right. Holding there, inhale. Exhale, stable, down goes your left heel. Feel your core working. And then glide the heel out, slide it back, and take it to the top. We'll do both. Breathe in as you exhale, like one big leg. Down, down, heels to the mat. Light touch, glide them out, slide them back, and slowly take them to the top again. Cup beneath your knees, pull them wide and down, and rock and roll side to side. The legs go up toward the ceiling, touch behind them and lift your head, and rock yourself up to seated. Let's get your ball in place. I'm using a 55 centimeter, but you can go a little smaller or a little bigger depending on your proportions. All right, the feet go on top of the ball to start. What you feel most are your calves on top of the ball. Your feet are suspended over the top now. For the footwork, breathe into your core. As you exhale, squeeze your glutes and lift the hips, press into your arms. If you need to, you can put your hips down. Keep going. Let's bend the knees and straighten. Exhale in and out. So the hips are stable in space as you pull in, squeeze out. Steady pressure into your arms, knees and feet together. Two more, like this. Last time, Pilates B, keep going in, zip, and pull in and out. Exhale, inhale. We're squeezing both ways, hips stable in space. Two more like this. And last time, hold it out there. Pulse the hips to the ceiling, go for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and hold. Parallel your feet, they touch. Breathe in as you exhale, pull the knees in, lift the hips high, and straighten the legs out. Articulate your spine to the mat. Pull the knees in, heels on the ball. Up you go, hips high, and straighten the legs out, and articulate down. Keep breathing, pull in, hips up, legs out, articulate down. Let's reverse that. Breathe as you exhale, lift the hips, pull the knees in so you're really high here. Keep your knees bent as you articulate down, down, and down. Legs out, hips up, knees bend, and then slowly take it down. See if you can leave your knees and feet together. And we'll do one more. Legs out, hips up. Pull the knees in, hips are super high, and down, down, and down you go. Pull your knees in towards your chest, and with your feet on the ball, rock and roll. We'll stretch your legs out shortly, don't worry. Extend the legs out, but this time put the ball behind the backs of your knees so you have more shin and feet suspended over the ball. Turn into Pilates V. Breathe into your core as you exhale. Squeeze your glutes and lift your hips. They're stable. For the 100s, keep your shoulders on the floor. And let's go. Breathe in through your nose. 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale through your mouth. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Check your spoke ribs, lats here. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Breathe in through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. 2, 3, 4, and 5. The hips stay super stable. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Check your spoke ribs, lats, and glutes. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Breathe in through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Neck stays long and relaxed. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Just two more sets to go. Exhale. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Last set. And exhale. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Hips down. Pull the knees in towards your chest. Keep your heels on the ball as you rock and roll side to side. Take the ball in your feet, give it to your hands, and slide the legs long out onto the mat. For the roll-up, roll down. You're in your core, neutral spine, Pilates V. Inhale, float your head up and put the ball on your thighs. Pitter-patter the ball down towards your feet and flex them. See if you can roll the ball to the top of the feet and breathe here. As you exhale, roll the ball up your shins. You want to turn out again. Squeeze your inner thighs and take this all the way down. Ball to the ceiling. Breathe in and float your head up as the ball goes to your thighs. Again, pitter-patter the ball down so we're not rolling it hand over hand. And then flex your feet. Get a good stretch. See if we can take it a little farther this time. Breathe in. Roll the ball up your feet and shins, knees, thighs, shoulders down and back. Take this all the way to your start point again. Inhale, head comes up, ball to the thighs, and roll it down. Flex your feet, see if you can get a really good stretch there, breathing. Then roll the ball up the legs again, shoulders down and back, changing up this time. Keep the ball on your chest. Roll it to your sternum bone. Breathe and float your head up. You're looking at the ball. And then pitter-patter the ball. Keep the ball on your chest, the thighs, the knees, the feet. Flex, breathe. Then roll it up the legs again. Scoop tight. Keep it on your chest to the sternum bone. We'll do one more. Head comes up. It follows the ball down your chest and legs. Keep scooping as you stretch out, flex your feet, breathe, then bring it back all the way down to the floor and down you go. Now, let's take the ball, put it between the indentation between calf and ankle. Give the ball a squeeze and turn your legs out slightly. For the roll over, breathe in, and as you exhale, scoop and tuck. Press into your arms and launch the legs over your head. Parallel your feet, flex the heels, breathe, and slowly take this down again. So each vertebra drops in sequence. Keep squeezing that ball with your inner thighs and turn out again. Scoop, tuck, press into the arms and launch the legs. Parallel your feet, flex the heels, inhale, and let's slowly take this down. And down, shoulders on the floor. It's arm work. And when you're down, turn out, hold. Drop the legs a little forward to a working level. We'll start from here. Scoop, tuck, drag those legs up and over. This time, put the ball on the floor carefully, right at the top of your head, and place your feet on the top of the ball. If this isn't for you, then take a break here. For a little control balance, right leg stretches up, up toward the ceiling. Sense that you're making a letter L with your legs. And then put that leg down. Let's do the other side. Squeeze your left glute, send the left leg up, up, up. Scoop tight and put that down. See if you can get the ball again. And take this down and down and down you go. Good, bend your knees, put the ball on the floor and walk it out. The ball is behind the back of your left knee on that connective tissue there. Turn it out a little bit. If you want to challenge, you can send the ball farther out toward the ankle or even right at the heel. So you decide where you want to be today with a single leg circle. The right leg goes up, left leg on the ball turned out. Breathe in as you exhale, lift your hips, press into your arms, and let's go. Across the body, down around to the outside and up. You are breathing, exhaling to the top. The work seems to travel around your abs here and up. We'll do one more this way. Hips stay stable, and let's reverse. To the outside and squeeze across and up. You feel the entire left leg from glute to heel is working. You're breathing out. Exhale, cross to the top. One more. Take it across to the top and put your hips down. Put the other leg on the ball. Choose where you want to be, behind the knee or the calf or the ankle. Left leg goes up. Turn the right leg out. Breathe as you exhale. Up you go. Press into your arms and let's go. Across the body, down around to the outside and up. You're breathing, exhaling to the top. The work seems to travel around your abs, outside and up. What you're feeling is a lot of stability in your arms and your hips. One more like this. Outside to the top, now reverse. To the outside and sweep it across and up. Breathing, exhaling, cross the body to the top. So check your scoop ribs, lats here, and arms and glutes. We'll do one more. Outside, cross to the top. Put your hips down, pull both knees in. With heels on the ball, rock and roll side to side. Take a wide stance, put feet on either side of the ball and float your head up. Let's rock up to seated and roll like a ball with a ball. Let's place the ball on the shelf of your feet to start. Your shoulders are down and back. You're looking at your navel and then get a grip on the ball. The shoulders need to be here and not unconnected there. So look at your navel, scoop it, and let's go. Breathe back, exhale, up to balance. Inhale, rock. And exhale, roll it up. You're breathing back. Exhale, up. We'll do one more. Rock. Roll it up. Hold. Now hug it in so it conforms to your body. Squeeze the knees into the sides. Come to balance. Then wrap your arms around the knees and maybe even the chin on the ball. Let's go. Breathe back. Exhale, up to balance again. Inhale, rock. Exhale, roll. You're breathing back in the structure, so everything's stable. We'll do one more. Rock. Roll it up. And the feet come down again. All right, put the ball on the floor. And roll back down. For the ab five. A lot of this is for your brain. Dig your right heel into the top of the ball. The left leg goes on diagonal over the ball. Breathe in and float your head up or leave it down. And pull the ball in twice with your right heel. Send the ball out, pull in twice with the left heel, and change hands. Extend out and pull, extend, and pull on the other side. You're sniffing, sniffing, extend, and blowing with your mouth open. So, sniff, sniff, and blow. Blow. So you're changing the ball each time. Breathing here and exhaling there. Your upper abs help keep your head up as you pull and pull, extend, shoulders down and back, extend. A couple of more each way like this. Extend, pull in with the left, Extend. One more each way. And last time. Good. Put your head down. Pull the ball in and touch the sides of your shins or your ankles. Float your head up or leave it down. Turn out a little Pilates V and extend all four. And pull right back in. Pilates V, parallel your feet in. Inhale, exhale, pull. Your torso and head never move, no matter where the head is. As you go out, and pull back in. We'll go for two more, like this. Last time, changing it up, we're going to pulse three times. Extend, inhale. And then exhale as you pulse three times and out. And pulse three times, inhale, out. And ha, 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 and out. Two more, pulse three times. Feel your abs. Last time. And out. Pull the ball in and put your head down. Cradle your head in your hands. Right heel on the ball, knee is bent, left leg extends on diagonal. For the crisscross, breathe and lift straight up first and then crisscross to your right knee. Head, legs, center, pull the ball in with your left heel and crisscross toward the knee. Extend, change, and crisscross right and center. Lift, crisscross left and center. Remember, your head is heavy in your arms here. And center, you feel the pinch in the left waist here. And center, and the right waist there. Elbows stay super wide. You're looking at the ceiling, so there's no stress in your throat and neck to pull the head up. And crisscross right. And center, one more time left. Take it to your right and hold. Let's pulse the knee in five times. Five, four, holding steady with your head, one and hold, and then pulse the shoulder towards your knee. Five, back a little, four, back a little. Remember, you're supporting your head and your hands. And two more, last time. Send the legs out, head center. Pull in with your left knee, suspend your right leg over it, and lift and crisscross toward it, hold. Let's pulse the knee in. Five, four, scoop tight, stay stable. Two, one, and hold. Now pulse towards your left knee with the shoulder. Five, and drop a little. And four, head heavy in the hands. Go for three, and back a little. Two more, last time. And good, extend the legs out. Heels on the ball, give yourself a stretch, arms over the head. Then pull it in, the feet give the ball to your hands, legs and arms up toward the ceiling. You can leave your head down for this one. Touch the ball with your right top of the foot and touch the ball with the left one. And touch, scoop tight and change and touch, change, touch and touch. Again, couple of more like this. Stay stable in your neutral spine. Last little set like this and ha, ha. Move the ball backward and flex your foot. Touch it with your toes. Reach for it and touch. And breathing here and exhaling there. Touch and touch. Again, couple of more like that. Scoop tight. Touch last time. And then good. Hold in the middle. Take the ball, put it in that indentation between calf and ankle again. Cradle your head in your hands. Give the ball a good squeeze. Inner thighs, you're turned out, and lift the head. Drop. Down. Don't touch the floor. And then up to the top. So keep a nice steady grip from your inner thighs down to the inside of the ankles. And up. Up, head hovers over the floor, looking at the ceiling. Your head is relaxed, it's dead weight. You feel the weight of your legs and the ball in your low abs. Let's add on next time. Drop down, pelvic floor active too. And as the legs come up, crunch. Look at the ceiling, don't use your throat, use your abs. And then we'll drop both down down to their start position. Let's do that again. Up, up, and upper body, lower body lifts, and back down, down. Stay connected here. And one more time. Remember, no stress in the throat or the neck. It's all abs compressing right there. And then back down, down you go. Put the ball on the floor, heels on top, and stretch out again. Just give yourself a nice break for a moment. Take a wide stance, hold behind your legs and float the head up and rock up to seated. For a version of the spine stretch, you have a couple of options. Ideally, you're at the back of your mat on your knees. The knees are wide. I'm going to give a little three-quarter turn so you can see. If you need to, you can dig the toes in if your feet tend to cramp. Otherwise, you're out on the floor with a super wide stance like this. Okay. Here we go. Your fingers are on the sides of the ball. Breathe into your core. As you exhale, drop your chin, scoop tight, and start to pitter-patter the ball out toward the end of the mat. You'll hold and breathe. So your hands are now splayed, and you're getting a nice little stretch here. Breathe again as you exhale. Scoop your belly tight. Now try not to lean on the ball. Put the work in your core to articulate back up and up, one vertebra at a time. Here go your shoulders into place, and the head is last. Do it again. Chin down. Articulate one vertebra at a time, down and down. So there's a real light touch on the sides of the ball. Finally, as you roll the ball, your spine and arms lengthen out. Breathe at the bottom. Get your stretch. Scoop your belly tight to start. Keep your hips low. Pitter-patter the ball up. Here goes your sacrum in space. Then each lumbar. Your mid-back. Shoulders roll into place. Head is last. We'll add on this time. Drop your chin. Pitter-patter the ball out. And hold low. Breathe here as you exhale. Splay your fingers and roll the ball on top of your right palm. Left hand is on the top now. Your head rests on your bicep and your hips make contact with the heels. We're just getting a stretch. Scoop your belly and roll through the middle and onto the top of your left palm. Right hand on the top. Hips low, breathing, getting the stretch, mainly on your right side, breathing. And we'll do that one more time each way. Roll it over to the right palm. You can keep going if you want to and increase the stretch, but keep your hips low. And through the middle, scoop there. And over to the left palm. And give it a good stretch, breathing. Come back to the middle, scoop your belly. And let's pitter-patter the ball back in. Here comes sacrum, lumbar, mid-back, shoulders roll into place, and there's your head. Great. Now, come to seated on top of the ball. Ideally, you're not exactly on top of the ball. You're at Greenland. So if you looked at the top of the ball as the North Pole, you would be sitting just south of it on Greenland. Take a wide stance. Make sure you can dig your heels in and feel stable. You might have to come off your mat and put the heels on the mat so you don't slide. Now, plant the feet wide. Arms go up. Breathe and rotate to your right. And saw. So down you go. And we're holding and breathing. Getting that much needed stretch in your left inner thigh. Breathing here. Then scoop your belly tight. Bend your knees, soles of the feet down, come up facing sideways. Through the middle you go, and saw. Breathe into that. So we're holding the stretches here. Inhaling and exhaling. Scoop belly, and up, up, up you go. Come up facing sideways. Through the middle, shoulders down. And so again, stretch it out. Both legs straight, feet pointing to the ceiling, breathing. And then retrace that, come up facing sideways. Through the middle you go, and saw again. Breathe into that. Scoop and lift your face sideways, soles of the feet down. Let's change it up a little. Through the middle, same hand to same leg. Just gonna open out a little more through your chest. Breathing into that. So nice spiral here, get a little more leverage. Scoop, bend the knees, come up facing sideways. Through the middle you go, same deal on the other side. Same hand to the inside of your leg. Press into it and saw and stretch and breathe. Scoop tight, bend the knees, come up to seated, facing sideways, back to the middle, and the arms come down. Great. Let's turn, move the ball back. You're sitting on the North Pole. Let's come into genie arms. If you find that your shoulders creep up like this, please drop them down. Your arms can even be pressing into each other to establish a connection here. You're in your core, drop your chin, scoop and tuck your pelvis, and take a decisive step out. And another, remember the spine is curving. And with the shoulders are down and back, you're going to come to about your mid-back. You can feel that on the ball. Breathing, still looking at your navel, take a decisive step back and start to curve up. And another step back. And another, stay in your core. And finally, elongate the spine. We'll do that again. Drop your chin, scoop and tuck your pelvis. Maybe step out with your other foot first. And then take another decisive step out. And another, and finally you feel about your mid-back. Breathe in, and as you exhale, keep your spine curved. And as you start to lift, you're curving upward, not leaning back. Finally, you're in a neutral spine again. Let's add on this time. Scoop, tuck. Take a step out. And another one, shoulders down and back still. Really connected in your abs. And finally, feet are together. Take both hands, maybe two fingers, and put them at the lowest part of your glutes. Let's do some little funny squats here. Your feet are about hip distance apart. Now, try not to lean back on the ball or else you miss a lot of work. So, scooping tightly, this places your lumbar square in front of that ball, right in the front face of the ball. And squeeze the glutes. You feel inner and outer thighs working. Couple of more like this. And good. Widen your stance a little. Remember, you're curved up from your upper back. All right, so if you're like this, you're gonna miss a lot of work. Shoulders down and back. The knees go wide, and now it's more like a little plie. And we're squeezing and plieing. Just a couple of more. Last time, scoop so tight, and then drop all the way to the floor. So you're breathing here. Take a wide stance with your feet. Support your head and straighten your legs. And just get a nice stretch here. So you're breathing. If you are proportioned so that your entire spine can drape over the top of the ball, maybe the ball is bigger too, then maybe your head can rest on the top of the ball and also your sacrum. Either way, you must support your head and neck. If you're using this method, holding your head with your fingers behind your head, then you're stretching your armpits, biceps, a little bit of pectoral too. You're breathing. Then, help your head up, bend your knees, and let's take this all the way down again. Great. And come up to seated. Mermaid style, let's flip the legs to the far end of your mat. You'll then turn and put your hands about shoulder distance apart on the top of the ball. So if you look at the ball as a clock face, your hands would be at about 11 and 1. Shoulders are down. You'll scoop your belly tight and press straight arms into the ball and lean into it. So there's no work in the fingers. It's all in the arms here. Breathe in as you exhale. Keep that steady pressure down and you'll roll the ball back to you. Remember, both shoulders stay down. And we'll do this again. Scoop your belly. If this is too much of a rotation, I'll show you on the next rep what you can do with your legs. And then press down. You feel all kinds of muscles firing across your mid-back, rear deltoids, triceps, rhomboids. If that's too much rotation, you bring your legs forward like this. Otherwise, if you want that nice rotation, keep going. Down, down, and down you go. Scoop tight, we're going to hold. Bend both elbows, but still press into your forearms and straighten them. So this goes into the biceps now. And your chest is wide, shoulders down, biceps active and out. Fingers are still inactive, really. We're not gripping the ball. And keep pressing down steadily and fall. We'll do one more. And in, out you go. Press steadily down and lift all the way up to seated. Let's change the feet slightly. Your top foot is going to the front corner of the mat. Your bottom foot goes to the back corner of the mat. Put the ball in the middle of the mat and sit up really straight so that when you stretch your legs out, you don't really overthink this beautiful stretch. The arm goes over your head. If you find that your head is not supported, creep your fingers and feet forward until you change the stretch so that you can rest your bicep and ear together. So you're breathing. Top arm is going to circle behind. And it goes forward. We'll do this again. Circles back. And forward. Adding on this time. As your arm goes back, push your belly forward. And as your arm goes forward, push your butt back. So we're just getting a little lateral movement going on here to accentuate the stretches. And again, butt back, arm forward. And belly forward, arm back. One more here. And then bring it back to center. Cradle your low ear in your hand. Bend your knees. Come to seated and bring your head with you. Let's change sides so the ball remains in the middle of the mat as you go down to the other end. You're in mermaid leg. Remember, this is an alternative if you don't like so much rotation, or you're here. Turn to face the ball. The hands are at about 11 and 1 or so. Shoulders stay down. Straighten your arms, maybe a tiny softened elbow, and out you go, breathing and pressing down into that ball from the back of the shoulders. And then keep that steady pressure down and lift up, up, up to the top. Let's do that again, breathing down, aware of what you're feeling across your shoulders, your mid-back, triceps, rear delts, rhomboids. Scoop your belly nice and tight here to stay stable. Breathing and exhaling. Remember, fingers are not in the picture. Let's take it out this time and hold. Steady pressure down with the forearms as you bend and straighten. Remember, shoulders stay down and back here. And out. Scoop your belly tight. You're at a perfect diagonal here. And we'll do a couple of more. Pull in, steady pressure down the whole time. Last time. Out and hold, breathe. And up, up, up you go to seated. Turn to face forward. Your top foot goes to the front corner. Bottom foot goes to the back corner. Sit up really straight, ball snugged in next to your waist. And stretch the legs out. The other arm goes over your ear. If your head is suspended, you really don't want that. Creep your fingers and feet forward until you can rest your head. That gives you a perfect stretch, very supported. Your top arm goes behind you. Feel the chest and shoulder open. it goes forward and you feel the back of the shoulder open and you feel a stretch along your side here. And we'll do this another time. And good, put it a lot into that stretch. And next time we'll add the torso. So as the arm goes forward, your butt goes back. As your arm goes back, your belly presses forward, really opening there. And butt back, arm forward. And reverse. And we'll do it again. And it goes back. And nice. The arm goes up and over. Hold your low ear in the palm of your hand. And simply bend the knees, come to seated, bringing your head with you. Up you go. Great. Let's turn and go to the very back edge of your mat. You're in your core and in neutral spine. Drape over your ball. Hands on the mat. We're going to be taking a step out one by one to the end of the mat. So stay in form. Take a step out and your legs start to come up like one big leg here. Squeeze your glutes and the feet are together and you're down at the very end in a plank. Breathe here and as you exhale, bend the elbows a little and straighten them. Bend and try not to pop the elbows. It's a squeeze up. And a couple more, scoop tight, stay in your plank. Last time. Good, adding on. Keep your arms straight, shoulders super fixed as you push back and forward. And do that again, back and forward. You want to add on, the legs swing up and forward. Scoop your belly tight, leave your legs together or else you destabilize. And legs up, forward, couple more. Last time. Adding on, don't overthink it. Back, forward, fold the knees and sit. If you pulled that off, great. Scoop your belly, your knees are slightly apart. Fix your shoulders and lift your right wrist and circle it. So you feel stabilizers kicking in there. Put your hand down and let's do the other side. So really fix your core, even though you're in this precarious position. And roll your left wrist around and put it on the floor. Now come up to a high kneel. Your knees come together now as good as they can. And let's trace little tiny circles. What you're doing is guiding this ball with your abs. So shoulders are fixed, belly is scooped, ribs are closed, and you're feeling the work travel around your abs, kind of like a corkscrew in regular mats class, and then reverse the circles, and circle, and good. Let's come back to seated for a moment. Extend the legs out into your plank again, and then start to walk backward. Good, knees find the floor, drape over your ball, and then come up. You'll find a suitable wall, even a door that's closed that no one's going to come barging into. And I'll put the ball at your lumbar spine against the wall. Now, step your feet outward a little so that you can actually come to a diagonal almost. So where feet are planted, you're stable, but you're in a little diagonal. Now, take your elbows and squeeze them into the ball. Right, so we're stable here. Bend both knees and straighten them. So we're not going to drop low, but what happens here is that we can glide up and down with our squats. Put the work in your glutes and upper legs, not your knees. Chest is wide. We've made sure of that with your elbows pressing into that ball. And down you go. Feel your glutes. You want to feel them? Put two fingers at the gluteal fold. And squeeze up. Feel inner and outer thighs too. We'll do one more like this. Good. Separate the feet a little so that your heels are in line with your sit bones. And let's do a demi-plie. You'll bend and squeeze up. So these are tiny little moves here, but they pack a big punch in your glutes and all around the upper thigh here. Down you go, chest wide, belly scoop, squeeze up. And breathe in. You feel like you could use only inner thighs, so even the toes are inactive. We'll go for a couple of more like this. Squeeze in up. Last time. Up. Take a wider stance. Breathe in and drop. Got more of a grand plié position now. If you want to, you can release the touching the glutes. I think you've got it. Keep the elbows there. And let's make some lateral moves. You're breathing. If you feel like you can keep your chest wide, you can put your hands on your hips. That's just so you don't go into any weird flexed position here. So we're going from side, of course you can feel it, to side. If this gets into your knees, come up a little bit. Otherwise, keep low. Belly scooped. Couple of more. And good. Let's hold it to one side or the other. And I want you to pulse here. Right into that side, tiny little moves. Breathing, check your chest, it should be wide, belly scooped. And through the middle, let's go to the other one. Pulse, little pulses, tiny movements, really feeling this engagement on the hip, the muscles surrounding it, your quad, your thigh. Two more. Come back to the middle, straighten it up, and toe heel it together. You'll turn now and face the wall, and your arms are stretched out. So if this was the wall in front of the ball, you'd be like this. The hands are really uninvolved on this one too. Squeeze your glutes, feet together, and keep your arms straight as you press the belly forward. So if you turn sideways, you'd look like a parenthesis. You're breathing. My hands are not gripping the ball. It's forearms. It's behind the shoulders. And my sternum bone is trying to lift. And then roll the ball back to shoulder height. Let's do that again. Up go the arms. And hold. So you're breathing here. And then roll it back, you're at perpendicular again. Let's keep walking the ball down the wall. And down you go. And finally put the hands on top of the ball and just give yourself a little forward bend. And then roll the ball in towards your feet and come up to standing again. Let's take a seat on top of the ball. You're sitting on the very top of the ball. And float your fingers just over your knees. So we're not going to use the arms in any way. Scoop your belly and tuck your pelvis. And then arch your back a little. I'll turn sideways so you see what I'm doing. The only thing that moves is from your rib cage down. So your ribs are stable. You'll tuck and release in a little arch. So as you can see, I'm not going with this. Ribs never move in space. It's just the lumbar, your pelvis. I'm using abs, then I release them. I use abs to tuck and then release them. One more time. Tuck, scoop, back to center. I'll turn back again so you see what I'm doing this time. We're going laterally. Breathe in as you exhale, pinch your right waist and then your left. So I'm not shoving off with the legs in any way. I'm using obliques and obliques. So what this isn't is this, all right? The ribs never move. You can even hold them there in space if you want to. You have a lot of activity under the fingers. Those are your obliques kicking in, couple of more. And good, hold in the middle. And let's make a complete circle, like a belly dancer. You'll tuck forward. Your oblique grabs it, gives it to a little arch in the back. The other oblique grabs it and gives it to the low abs forward. So nothing moves from the rib cage to your head. It's all in the pelvis and your waist, the muscles, the fronts, the sides, the back muscles, and hold and reverse wherever you are. And around you go, breathing and exhaling. And remember, the rib cage never moves. One more round and hold. Good, just drop it forward. Give yourself a little stretch through here. And then come back to seated. You can, you're long. One more beautiful stretch here. Drape over the ball again. The breasts are off the front and your head, it depends on the proportions of your ball and your body. Your elbows are down, maybe the knees float just over the mat. Maybe your head and knees are down. If you need support, cross your palms and put your head on the top hand. Feel the opening in your spine. You're breathing laterally. If you feel a pulse in your belly against the ball, that is perfectly normal. And fill in your sides here as you breathe. We're just trying to relax and release. The vertebrae themselves are easing away from each other, releasing tension there, especially around the lumbar, which tends to curve, of course, in towards your gut. Now it's got a gentle curve up toward the ceiling. And you're breathing, holding stable, observing what's happening. Let's do a couple more really deep breaths laterally. And exhale. One more time, as deep a breath as you can go, laterally. And exhale. To come out of this, I want to press the knees to the floor and hold, even if they're already down. So we're going to start making our way backward, slowly. Please don't do this quickly. Stay glued to the ball, so your chest never comes up. We're still walking backward. Finally, you rest your hips on your heels. You can dig your toes in if necessary. Stay draped over your ball. And then slowly, you'll feel gravity start to kick in again and weight the vertebra in toward each other as you slowly come up to seated. Come to seated on top of the ball. Let's cross the ankles. Do it kind of fast. Scoop your belly. You're already feeling stabilizer muscles. Cross your wrists, lace your fingers now. You can leave them here or turn them. You decide. You have a neutral spine in space and your belly is scooped, and yet you're still feeling little stabilizer muscles. I am. This is good. We've put them on an unstable surface in a controlled atmosphere with a soft mat and a big fun ball. So let them have at it. We're putting this into muscle and cerebral memory so that you can take all of this neuro information with you and bring it back to your next class. With that, let's fairly quickly uncross. Feet and knees still together. Bring your palms together, looking straight ahead, eyes open. Look down your cheeks, eyes open. Relax your shoulders and close your eyes. Another new set of stabilizer muscles with your eyes closed. You're breathing, scooping, neutral spine, letting them twitch for a moment. And finally, open the eyes, uncross, move around just a little bit, and there's your class today.